Neighbor friends, I welcome you to Catholic Marriage Forum. The theme of our marriage teaching on marriage is sexual intimacy in marriage. Dear friends, do you know that several marriages today suffer breakdown because of lack of proper understanding of sexual intimacy in marriage? The Christian understanding of sex in marriage is that sex in marriage is a sacred art. John Paul II says that sexual intimacy in marriage is something that is not purely biological but concerns the innermost being of husband and wife. Sex is something that is proper and exclusive to married people. Thus, it is a grave sin for a married person to have sex outside marriage. It is also a grave sin for someone who is not married to have sex. Now, I want you to note that there is a twofold purpose of sexual intimacy in marriage. One is procreative purpose. Two is unity purpose. Procreative purpose means that every sexual act ought to be open to generation of life. It ought to be open to fecundity. God gives us our sexual faculties that we may use them to participate in His creative work, that we may use them to propagate, that we may use them to bring about generation of life. Thus, it is out of place for a married person to begin to use various forms of contraceptives because such contraceptives inhibit these procreative purposes. The second purpose is unity purpose. Sex brings about the unity of body and soul. Sex increases the love between the husband and wife. In sex, the words of Jesus in Matthew chapter 19 verse 6, that they are no longer two, but they are one flesh, finds its fulfillment. Thus, a spouse should not deny his or her spouse sex unless for a serious reason, as a policy. My dear friends, I want you to know that when you involve or when you engage in sexual act, you know that what you are doing is something that is not purely biological. In fact, St. Paul says that how can a man join his wife to another prostitute, to a prostitute? That is to tell you that in sexual acts, a man joins himself to his wife, so they become one. So today, I want you to know that sex is not something purely biological. There are a lot of teachings about sexual intimacy that many people listen to, but some of these teachings are contrary to Christian teaching on marriage. Note this, that in engaging in sexual acts, that act ought to be open to generation of life. So when you do that, you are participating in the creative work of God. I pray that God will bless you and give you the grace to understand your vocation as a married man, as a married woman. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. God bless you.